Good afternoon. Thank you very much, Apostolos, for the invitation and the opportunity that we have to present the ship owners, the ship managers, if you want, views and approach on this issue, on this concept, as we, the last few years, we discussing and we say a lot of things about sustainability. And as we can see, as a strategic choice. Very briefly, I'm going to present a few things regarding the concept of sustainability in the more broad, let's say, approach. And in continuation, I'm going to present what IMO, what is the IMO strategy in our days with regards to sustainability. Then, a few things about what we believe in capital management we can do about that, and concluding with the benefits. As I said, very briefly, we're talking about sustainability or corporate social responsibility or this very close or, if you want, similar concepts. Generally speaking, we're talking about sustainable management or sustainable development or environmental responsibility or the corporate social responsibility, as we heard a few things and another approach earlier on this panel, social responsibility or and triple bottom line. Very simply, sustainability is the whole. Three main elements, three pillars, three P's. People, planet, and profit. We know the three pillars, the three P's of sustainability are the economic, the social, and the environmental. Especially our industry, shipping industry, is heavily, I would say, regulated as far as it concerns the environmental regulation legislation worldwide, not only international but local as well. This one thing that is very, very important for us is to have in our minds that sustainability cannot exist at any time without the balance between those three pillars. It's not possible to have this approach compromising the one or the other pillar. So should be a balance between these three elements. Our industry, the international shipping, have some goals. To be safe and secure, we know what it's all about, of course. Environmentally responsible, reliable, and of course, efficient, low cost. In simple words, in practical words, I would say, should be sustainable. And we can see, I'm not going because I know it's not very easy to read, in the whole life cycle of a vessel, meaning from construction to operation, from design to construction, to operation, final to disposal. The three elements, the sustainability concept, the sustainable approach is there in different aspects on each stage of the life cycle of a vessel. Another, you see? And the most important thing I would say to this one is to be practical, because otherwise will be another theoretical, let's say, concept with difficult strategies to be implemented or to be achieved at this case. Now, the IMO starting 2 years ago to have a more, let's say, close approach to the sustainable maritime development. It was in front of Rio plus 20. And last year, 2013, we have a paper issued, an approach, a position statement, let's say, from IMO regarding the sustainability and IMO strategy on that. And you can see it's beyond Rio plus 20. So, very briefly, IMO strategy right now is the following. 10 main principles. I'm going to show you these 10 principles. First of all, what is needed in order to the maritime transport system, the shipping industry, to be sustainable? first of all, safety culture, environmental stewardship, education and training. We know, all of us, we know how important is the education and training of our seafarers, and additional within maritime profession and support for seafarers. Energy efficiency and support interface, energy supply for ships, fuels, alternative sources, alternative types of fuel, maritime traffic support and advisory systems, the maritime security, the technical cooperation, new technologies, innovations, I would say here, new designs, new hulls, new engines, of course, finance, liability, and insurance mechanisms, and finally, the ocean governance. This is the 10 main principles, the 10 principles, I would say, of IMO's strategy regarding sustainability and sustainable shipping industry. Now, what are our views on that one as a company, and what we're trying to, let's say, achieve or to implement as part of this strategic approach? So, very briefly, I'm only a few bullet points on each one regarding the safety culture and environmental stewardship. First of all, of course, the IMO regulations, implementation of industry best practices and the IMO regulations, it's mandatory for all of us. But what about to go beyond regulations, have a beyond regulations approach, I would say a more proactive approach. Safety culture campaigns, including zero accident approach, which is very, very important based on this strategy. Activities on partnerships with authorities and other industry parties. For example, post-end controls, sometimes on US Coast Guard, and classification societies or other industry parties. This is what we're doing regarding this one. Now, regarding education and training in maritime profession and support for seafarers as a principle, what we are trying to do is to elevate the profile of maritime education with several actions, I would say. We have dedicated training centers and also through these centers we're trying to retain, first of all, and in continuation to give the opportunity for further development of our seafarers, promotion of onboard training, continue to recognize the role of human element, in particular with respect to new technologies and innovations. This is part of our, I would say, new buildings program, but also as part, also in part of the in operation stage, what we are doing aboard the vessels right now. And I'm saying again, human element goes beyond the requirements, if you want, or the regulation, for example, ILO, MLC, etc. Now, about the energy efficiency and support interface, a lot of discussions, presentations, papers, we know all of us regarding the energy efficiency, which is one of the hottest topics in our days. Implementation of energy efficiency measures through several sources. Earlier this morning, we discussed about the SEMP, Ship Energy Efficiency Management Plan, and other measures. Promote the use of standardized single window electronic systems, for example, to virtual arrival, when and where is possible, of course. I'm not saying that this is possible to happen 100%, but when and where is possible. Coordination of activities for intelligent use and terminal spaces and cargo handling infrastructure with good communication cooperation with all industry parties, for example, the charterers, the cargo receivers, through agencies and everything. This is something that we're trying to do that. And we succeed in a high, in a good level, I would say. Regarding the energy supply for ships, and as I said earlier, we're talking about fuels. We heard again on this panel about fuels. And investigate potential use of other sources of energy, for example, LNG, take into consideration projection of future supply and demand or cost. We know what's all about. There's a number of projects right now that we're examining, or we're trying to see what could be happening regarding the LNGs, LNG as a fuel, or combined sources, or whatever. and of course safety, consideration of safety aspects in conjunction with the usage of new type of fuels, because it's very, at least for my point of view, it's very good to say about the new sources of fuels, for example, LNGs or similar approaches, but or methanol sometimes, but what about the safety aspects of such kind of implementation? We have to take into consideration, especially for the new designs. Maritime traffic support and advisory systems, use of electronic systems from VTS areas. Additionally, I would say, and this is something I'm working on that right now, is to standardize the standardization of age of navigation operation of onboard navigation equipment, including optimization of egg disuse with further sources of data. And I think that is a good opportunity as we have some the developments in front of us the next couple of years, less than a couple of years, regarding EGDIS. Maritime security, another hot topic, I would say, promote and strengthen the guidance on prevention for preventing and defensive measures to protect ships from security threats, support regional measures to address maritime security risk and efforts, to share info, knowledge and resources. What we are trying to do here is to, one of the most important things is to share not the knowledge, but the experience and the resources and the information that we may have through regarding this. And of course, because as we have in very good cooperation with professionals on that area, we are in close cooperation with them. Technical cooperation, coordination, implementation of technical cooperation and capacity of building activities. For example, when we build some of, of our new vessels, we try to transfer the know-how as well as we have the experience from previous designs, as well as the development of new capacity building delivery mechanism. Innovation, new technology, develop and maintain mechanisms of relevant technology systems to comply with the new and or existing, of course, legislation regulations, starting with the new designs and technologies for example, which is very, very important, as we know, and the EEDI compliant vessels, the design index. Finally, which is, I would say, more straightforward for big ship management companies like our company, which already we are listed. Financial liability insurance mechanism, financial security deriving from broad, I would say, ratification implementation of international liability. This is normal, it's logical. You cannot afford not to have, I would say. And finally, the ocean governance, which is a lot of movements, I would say, in our days to engage in use of seas, initiatives and informations, information sharing with a view to participate in trade, environmental and safety aspects. And very, only a few things, I would say this Arctic navigation as we discussed earlier. Yes, please. special areas, environmentally sensitive areas. This is something that a number of interested parties in our days is asking. Now, in order to conclude, what are the benefits of such kind of approach, as we believe that this approach is a strategic approach for a company, for a ship manager, for a shipping company, especially in order to cope with the challenges that we have in front of us, to raise the profile of, first of all, the maritime sector, as well as the shipping companies which are implementing this approach. Highlight the strategic approach and chosen by this shipping company in order to contribute to a more sustainable maritime sector. Very, very important, engaging the partners because you cannot do all this without engaging and being in close cooperation with all the interested parties and partners, and to achieve major supply chain efficiency gains. Of course, provide safe, healthy, and secure work environments, as far as it concerns the human element. Exploring ways to put a financial value on ecosystems, goods, and services to ensure responsible resource use and reduce ecosystem impacts. And final, to develop new financial solutions that reward sustainable performance and enable large scale of implementation of innovation, technology, design, and of course, operational efficiency. Thank you very much for your attention. Thank you.